Welcome to Pioneer of Success. This is the third video of the series COMSOL Multiphysics for Researchers. Before we move on to the technical discussion, here is something about myself. In this particular lecture, we have planned to discuss about physical problems with COMSOL Multiphysics. In this part also, I have splitted the discussion into three sections. The first thing, you have to understand each point of COMSOL Multiphysics, equations, modifications of equations, and how to put boundary conditions. Also, you have to learn how to couple physics, because there might be several physics in your problem. Then you should have knowledge of particular COMSOL modules that will be required for your problem. So you are targeting a particular problem, and what are the physics will govern those particular problem, that you have to know. And from that knowledge, you have to know what are the COMSOL modules you will be using, and that you have to segregate. Then comes, make assumptions to simplify your problems and run the simplified form initially. Then remove assumptions one by one to tackle the ultimate problem. That means we have to assume many things so that our equations become very simple and we can model it. We can put appropriate boundary conditions and we can run the simulation. Then one by one, if we just increase the complexity, then what will happen? The debugging of error will become very easy. Otherwise, what may happen? You put all the equations together, all the boundary conditions, complex boundary conditions, then the simulation is not running. So that will create a problem. That is why my suggestion is to break down the problem into many parts. Then make assumptions. Based on the assumptions, reach to a simplified problem, start that simplified problem, and then put one by one complexity. So in this particular video, I'll be taking one COMSOL problem where I'll be discussing what are the physics we have taken, why did we take all those physics, and how did we model that particular thing, and what are the other things associated with that modeling. So the model which I will be talking about today is on microfluidic mixture driven by electroosmosis. So in this particular problem, we had three modules, and those were laminar flow module, which takes care of the fluid flow, electrostatic module that tackles electroosmotic flow. This is actually solving the electric field, and the electric field is associated with the electroosmotic flow. I'll talk in detail during the COMSOL discussion. And the next one is transport of diluted species module, that comes because you need to solve a particular, actually this is a mixture, so there you have to mix something, so one component will be there that is under mixing, that is why you have to take a transport component, and that is governed by transport of diluted module. So before I move on to COMSOL, I would like to request you to subscribe to my channel so that you will be getting more videos. Now I move on to COMSOL interface. So this is a COMSOL interface. I have already simulated a problem, because I'll be discussing the things one by one. The simulation I am not teaching here, because you already know how to put equations, how to put boundary conditions. So in this video I'll be just discussing about the physics in more detail. So the first one is, I'll show you the parameters. Few parameters I have already enlisted here, and those parameters are this, that is U0, that is mean inflow velocity, some parameters sigma W, that is a conductivity of water, ionic water, and other things like zeta potential. We are dealing with electroosmotic problems, so the wall will have some zeta potential, that's why we have defined a value of zeta. We have defined other required parameters like start time t equal to 0, like diffusivity of the components. So these are liquid components, so diffusivity is falling in the range of 10 to the minus 11, and also C0, that is the initial value of the component that is under mixing. So our target is, we have a channel like this. So this is the mixture section. So fluid is coming from here, and electroosmosis is taking place in this particular zone, and because of electroosmosis, one mixing or the flow mixing is happening, and that flow mixing is creating the mixing of the component that we have taken here. So we have to study this. we have taken a step function. I'll show you why did I take this step function. The step function is taken to take care of the concentration inlet. I'll show in more detail. In geometry section, we have taken these things in order to make this model. This is very simple. In another video, I'll be telling how to draw different things in COMSOL multiphysics. That will be taken care of in a separate video. So there are three physics. One is laminar flow. So I'll now discuss about the laminar flow. If you go to the equation, you can see this is continuity equation and this is Navier-Stokes equation, or you can say this is momentum balance equation. Now I will go to fluid properties. The fluid properties are taken from the material. So we have taken a material, we have put the value. So the rho and mu values are taken from that material. Now important thing is wall 1. So we have make these things wall 1. That means the portions which are being shown in blue color, those are walls, and that is wall 1. In wall 1, what we did, we have made it electroosmotic wall. What is that mean? It means some zeta potential will be there on these walls, and it will undergo electroosmosis if there is some potential difference. You can see here we have incorporated the zeta potential. That means the value of the potential at certain point on the wall. We have also taken relative permittivity. This is the relative permittivity of the solution, because we are solving now laminar flow. In laminar flow, we have a fluid that is flowing inside the channel, and that fluid has some parametric values. That means value of the epsilon r. Now we'll go to inlet 1. So in inlet 1, we have incorporated average velocity. So u0, I have already defined the parameter section which I have already shown you, and u0 the particular value has been taken, and that I put here. I have another outlet. You can see in outlet I have kept pressure zero condition. That means atmospheric pressure. This is the gauge pressure, that's why this is under atmospheric pressure. So for laminar flow, what I did, I put one inlet condition, one outlet condition, and walls are taken at electroosmotic velocity condition. Again, I'll go to wall. You can see the electroosmotic conditions are also given. This EX is coming from this particular physics, electric current. So we'll go to electric current. So I'll show you the equation which we are solving here. So those are the equations for solving electric field, and that is why we have taken this particular equation. So the important thing is you have to understand what are the physics governing your problem. In this particular case, we are solving electroosmosis, and we know that we have to take electric current equation. In PPT I told you electrostatics. If you take electrostatic, that will also work. Then you have to define your rho v. The thing is you have to know the equation. So those equations are valid for electroosmosis. That is why electric current is also working. If you take electrostatics, that will also work, but you have to make the equation in that format. Now I'll show you other things. That is a current conservation. That is one condition we have to take here. So in this particular section, the material properties are being taken. You can see here electrical conductivity, relative permittivity, all those values we are putting, all are coming from the material itself. Material means the fluid inside the microchannel. Electric insulation, we have made these portions electrically insulated, and the other portions, I'll come to this now, that is electric potential one. So this part we have kept at minus V0, and the other two, these two portions, we have kept at V0. So that means there is a change of potential on the wall, and that change of potential will create some sort of mixing, because flow reversal will take place, electrostatic flow reversal, and that will create mixing. Now I'll come to transport of diluted species. Why we have taken this? This particular thing is taking care of the mixing of the components. So what we are studying in this particular problem? We are studying mixing of component C, and that is why we have to have equations for component C, and that equation is nothing but transport equation. You can see the equation. This is the equation. So this part is your diffusive part, this part is convective part, and this is coming because of reaction. For this case, we have not taken any reaction, so this part automatically becomes zero. So we are solving diffusive and convective equation, convection diffusion equation. Now again, transport properties. In transport properties section, we have taken the properties like diffusivity, that D is already defined in parameter section, so we are directly taking from the parameter enlisted part. One important thing is it requires U. In the equation I have shown you, there is a term U dot delta C. So that U is coming from the laminar flow, which I have already discussed about. So that laminar flow physics is nothing but SPF. So here these two equations are coupled, laminar flow and transport equations are coupled, and we made the coupling with this, with the help of this part. So here we are taking the value of U from laminar flow. Now I go to concentration 1. So we kept one particular concentration, so we are putting a concentration as a step function, and that step function is defined earlier. So at inlet we have a step function of concentration, and at the outflow we are maintaining normal flux condition. So my boundary conditions and equations are defined. So I'll go to meshing part. So in this particular part, I'll also tell you, meshing has been done in a special way. We have made customized mesh. In this particular case, you can see near the portions where we applied electric field, we made the mesh more fine. These four portions, because electroosmosis is taking place in these sections, and other section we made broader mesh, not fine, because we do not concentrate on that part. Our focus is on mixing, flow mixing, and also component mixing. That is why we made those portions very fine. So accordingly, for your problem also, you may have to customize your mesh. That depends on your physical problem. So those are the things I wanted to convey. So after this, we went to study. There were two studies, stationary and also time dependent. So in stationary, we have solved all the physics. And after solving, we obtained this results. I'll show you the mixing one. Yeah, this is the profile for component C. You can see in this zone where electroosmosis is taking place, the concentration of the component is diffused. That means diffusion is taking place, the mixing is taking place. But in this sections where electroosmosis is not taking place, the prominent mixing we cannot see. So that was the main target of this study. We wanted to make one electroosmotic mixture by changing the voltage that will create flow vortices. And also that flow vortices, you can see, we have also plotted the stream lines. These are the stream lines. You can see on the contour, the stream lines of the flow is being shown. So in this particular problem, we have solved liquid flow, and that liquid flow is giving me the information of the flow. If you can see here how the flow is distributed, we have also solved the component diffusion, that is C. You can see the profile for C, and also electric field. So in the next video, we will be coming up with another problem, and we will be discussing about the problem so that you understand how to model with COMSOL. So in this particular section, for this series, we will be discussing problems taking from different fields. Like in this video, we have discussed about microfluidic mixture. In some other video, we will be discussing about wave optics, we'll be discussing about solid mechanics, so that people from different field can catch our videos, and that will be helpful for them. So thank you very much.